مرحبا وأهلا وسهلا فيكم. Hello and welcome. I help students like you speak Arabic and not just learn about it. My mission is to help you get speaking Arabic and overcome all the obstacles and difficulties that are between you and fluency. Before we start, why don't you visit the link down below to get your free copy of the Levantine Lebanese Spoken Arabic Conversation and Phrasebook, free of charge. Check the link down below. ويلا, let's begin. مرحبا وأهلا وسهلا فيكم. بهيدا الدرس رح نحكي عن الأعياد والمناسبات, holidays and occasions. First of all, I'd like you to think about the following question. شو هو العيد المفضل عندك أو عندك؟ What's your favorite holiday? Now let's go through some important verbs to speak about holidays and occasions. خلونا نحكي عن شوية أفعال مهمة تتعلق بالأعياد والمناسبات. احتفل, to celebrate. احتفل, يحتفل. And we have to use it in conjunction with the preposition be. Now that's very important because in English you say to celebrate a birthday. You don't really use a preposition, but in spoken Arabic you have to, and even in standard. So, احتفل بي. For example, أنا عم بحتفل بعيد ميلادي. I'm celebrating my birthday. So I use بي. هني عم يحتفلوا براس السنة. They're celebrating New Year. We have to use بي. In English we don't. But in Arabic, we use B. The gerund is احتفال, احتفال. And the plural, احتفالات, احتفالات, with an alif and a ta over here. To decorate, زين, يزين. تزيين is the noun. For example, let's say she's decorating the tree. هي عم تزين الشجرة. هي عم تزين الشجرة. زيني is decoration. هي عم تحط الزينة على الشجرة. She's putting the decoration on the tree. هدية is a present. هدية. هدايا is the plural. Presents. هدايا. To hang something on the tree, such as she's hanging the decoration on the tree, هي عم تعلق الزينة على الشجرة. verb علق. So the qaf over here is generally pronounced as a glottal stop. So علق, يعلق, على, to hang on something. تعليق is the gerund. Now verbs to invite, we have two over here, عزم and دعا. عزم يعزم, عزيمة. دعا يدعو, دعوة. For example, هو عزم أصحابه على العشاء. أو هو عزم أصحابه على المؤتمر. He invited his friends for dinner or he invited his friends for the conference. المؤتمر. بطاقة دعوة. An invitation card. And to say an invitee, مدعو. The واو is geminated over here. So when we change it to the plural, مدعوين. It's going to be a double واو. مدعوين. So invitees. هني المدعوين, they are the invitees. Obviously, you can exchange عزم with دعا, so you can use either or. But let's say I want to say I got an invitation for dinner. إجتني عزيمة على العشاء, أو إجتني دعوة على العشاء, either or. عيد is a holiday. عطلة is a day off, like عطلة نهاية الأسبوع, the weekend, or the end of the week, literally. عطلة رسمية is an official holiday, like a bank holiday. رسمي means official, so obviously we use a feminine adjective, رسمية, because عطلة is feminine. And مناسبة is an occasion, مناسبة. عيد ميلاد is a birthday. عيد ميلاد, ميلاد means birth. Literally. So when we speak about Christmas, which is the birth of Jesus Christ, it's عيد الميلاد. عيد الميلاد. So with the alif lam over here in the form of noun annexation. عيد الميلاد. The عيد of the birth, literally. عيد of the birth, literally. عيد رأس السنة, New Year. رأس means head. رأس in standard and in colloquial, we do not pronounce the glottal stop. We pronounce it as رأس instead of رأس. So literally means the beginning, because the head is the top, you know, or the beginning of something, hence the new year. So the beginning of the year. عيد رأس السنة. Christian holidays, أعياد مسيحية. عيد الفصح, Easter, عيد الفصح. And عيد الميلاد, obviously. Now with Islamic holidays, we have two main ones. العيد الكبير, which is the major one. عيد الأضحى. عيد الأضحى. أضحى means corresponds to sacrifice. And that's why it's called عيد الأضحى. And it's the major Islamic holiday. And we call it the big عيد, العيد الكبير. عيد الفطر is the small عيد. And it's the one that marks the end of the fasting month of Ramadan. And in Arabic, we refer to it as العيد الصغير, the small عيد, literally. So you will have both types of عيد, Christian and Islamic, obviously in Lebanon. عيد الشكر, Thanksgiving Day. So عيد الشكر. Now this is not a typical Arabic holiday or Lebanese holiday, but this is the translation because شكر means thanks. And you know, شكراً means thank you. So عيد الشكر, Thanksgiving Day. 4th of July, الرابع من تموز. 4th of July, أو الرابع من يوليو, if we're using, for example, the calendar in Egypt, like the Gregorian calendar. But in Lebanese, we would say تموز. الرابع من تموز. Independence Day, عيد الاستقلال. عيد الاستقلال. استقلال is independence. اللي هو ب22 تشرين الثاني. The 22nd of November. تشرين الثاني. دول ما بتحتفل بعيد استقلال. A list of countries that do not celebrate Independence Day. مثل نيبال, Denmark, Thailand, Canada, فرنسا, روسيا والصين. عيد زواج is literally an anniversary. For example, اليوم رح نحتفل بعيد زواجنا. Today we're going to celebrate our anniversary, our wedding anniversary. تعميد, christening. تعميد. عيد العمال, labor day, because عامل is a laborer or a worker. عيد العمال, عمال in the plural means workers or laborers. April Fool's Day, كذبة أول نيسان. نيسان is April, أول is the ordinal number, which means the first. كذبة is a lie. The is pronounced as a z in Lebanese, so كذبة, a lie, كذبة أول نيسان. And it can be referred to in several ways, كذبة أبريل أو كذبة نيسان. Obviously, أبريل أو أفريل in the Gregorian calendar, كذبة نيسان in the Lebanese Levant calendar. أو كذبة أول نيسان. هي مناسبة تقليدية بعدد من الدول. So it's a traditional occasion, مناسبة تقليدية in several countries, بعدد من الدول. هي منا يوم وطني, it's not a national day, أو رسمي أو official, بس يوم تعود الناس فيه على المزح. But a day that people got used to joking around in it, literally. المزح, joking around. With تنكيت. So, مزح and تنكيت means joking and telling jokes. هو عم يمزح. He is joking. وهو عم ينكت. He's telling jokes. والخداع and trickery. خدعة is a trick. خداع, trickery. وإطلاق الشائعات والأكاذيب. So, and literally letting out rumors and lies. شائعة is a rumor. شائعات in the plural. أكذوبة is a lie, أكاذيب in the plural. Now to say Happy New Year, or even happy birthday, or literally for even for like any type of Eid, regardless of whether it's personal or general, non-personal, I mean like official or religious, we have a saying, so which is كل سنة وأنت بخير. Obviously, أنت to a female addressing you in the feminine, وأنتو بخير in the plural. It literally means every year and you are good, the literal meaning. So that will mean may you find goodness every year. May you be good every year. May you be well and good every year. كل سنة وأنت بخير أو أنتو بخير in the plural. You can also alternate سنة with عام. عام also means a year. كل عام وأنت بخير. كل عام وأنت بخير. كل عام وأنتو بخير in the plural. And we have also the same thing, but in a way we're saying, may this holiday return again for you. ينعاد عليك. أو ينعاد عليكي, addressing the female. أو ينعاد عليكم, addressing the plural. May it return again for you or repeat itself again for you. We can add things like ينعاد عليك بالصحة والسلامة. صحة is health and سلامي is safety. So may it return again for you with health and safety. ينعاد عليكي to a female بالصحة والسلامة. ينعاد عليكم بالصحة والسلامة in the plural. عيدية is to those of you who don't know, a monetary gift or money that is given typically from the adults of the family to the little children who will use that money to buy sweets, crackers, or to maybe attend like certain fairs, or to save the money and so on. عيد الموتى, that would be in Mexico, for example, Day of the Dead. يوم الموتى, Day of the Dead. يوم الموتى. في عيد مميز أو غريب ببلدكم؟ شو هو؟ Think about this as well. Have you got any special or strange holiday in your country and what is it? هذا كان كل شيء وشكرا لكم ولانتباهكم. Thank you for your attention and for watching.
شكرا للمتابعة. Thank you for watching. Make sure to click on the channel icon and go to the store button to check out some cool merchandise.